Let us now look at this question. Paul is the manager of a railway company which runs exactly five trains, train A, B, C, D, and E, with each train connecting exactly two cities. Okay. None of the trains stop at any city other than the origin and destination. Okay. The total cost for each trip of a train for the train to reach the destination from origin comprises of three types of cost: fixed cost, variable cost per passenger, and variable cost per kilometer. These are the three different components. Okay. Variable cost per kilometer varies directly with distance covered. Of course, kilometer में तो distance covered सही होगा. In the table below provides for train A through train E the fixed cost in USD, variable cost in USD per passenger and variable cost in USD per kilometer for each train. It is known that the distances travelled by train A through train E in each trip are in the ratio 1 is to 2 is to 3 is to 4 is to 5 respectively. Okay. So in a sense, they've made variable cost also fixed because they've given you the ratio of the distances travelled in each of the trains. So you can say the cost here. If distance travelled by A is X, cost here is 8X, 8 into X, 2 into 2X, cost here is 4X, cost here is 18X, cost here is again 18X, and the last one 5 into 13.5. 17.5x. The variable cost per kilometer, depending on what distance A is traveling, would be 8x, 4x. If the distance traveled by A, if distance by A is x, these are the variable cost per kilo. These are the cost per kilometer. अब तो variable भी नहीं रहा, अब तो cost आ गया उनका distance वाला. ठीक है. क्वेश्चंस पढ़ते आगे क्या क्या बता रखा है. इफ द टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ अ ट्रिप फॉर ट्रेन ए एंड दैट फॉर ट्रेन सी वाज द सेम एंड एग्जैक्टली 100 पैसेंजर्स ट्रैवल्ड इन ईच ट्रेन ऑन दैट ट्रिप, व्हाट इज द टोटल डिस्टेंस इन किलोमीटर ट्रैवल्ड बाय ट्रेन ए इन दैट ट्रिप. ओके, लेट्स फाइंड आउट टोटल कॉस्ट फॉर ट्रेन ए. सो ए के लिए कॉस्ट है 600 और सी के लिए फिक्स्ड कॉस्ट है 450. चलेगा. There were 100 passengers in each train. तो ऊपर variable cost passengers का लगा 500 और नीचे लगा है 250 क्योंकि 2.5 per passenger. Now variable cost per kilometer 8x and 18x. Okay, let's cancel stuff out. I get 150 here. I get 250 here. I get 10x here. This was data for A, this is data for C. So 10x with A is equivalent to 400. 10x with C is equivalent to 400 with A, or x is equal to 40. Answer of the first question is obtained. I could have also made an equation and solved it, but this seems easier because there are three distinct parts and all these three distinct parts are easy to manage with each other. Okay. Let's go ahead. Next is, if the total cost of a trip for train C and train D was same and exactly 50 passengers traveled in train D, how many passengers traveled in train C? Oh, 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 wonderful. So let's look at the data for C and D. Let me remove this line. In C, 450. We don't know the variable cost per passenger, so 2.5x per C, that is what we have to identify. And then variable cost, I can't use x here, let me use p, 2.5p, and then you have 18x as variable cost per kilometer cumulative here. For D, the same cost you have are 650. 8.5p, and also 18x. Okay, I don't have to do 8.5p because they have told me the number of passengers in D. So 8.5 into 50 should be 425. Okay, see, variable cost per kilometer is identical in both, so it is no longer a factor. 450 and 650 cancel out to give me 200. So I'm getting 2.5p is 625. 2.5p is equal to 625, or p is equal to 250. I can happily answer this question. It will be option C. I think I should remove these things now because the next questions require some writing. Hopefully you understood question 1 and 2, what I have done. I am simply comparing the individual cost for fixed cost and variable cost per passenger and variable cost per kilometer. You can make equations and compare, not a problem. I prefer doing this. It is better to handle for me. Okay, coming to the next question now. If an equal number of passengers traveled in the 5 trains and the total cost of trip for train E was the highest, the number of passengers that traveled in any train must be. Okay. Can you see that train E will always cost more than train A? If the number of passengers are equal, fixed cost is higher, variable cost per passenger is higher, and variable cost per kilometer 17.5x and 8x, E will always cost more than A. So A is not even necessary for our comparison. Let's look at E and B. 750 and 500, 6.5 and 7, 3.5 and 2, 17.5x and 4x. Okay. In this case, if you see, variable cost per passenger is higher for B, is lower for E, which means if you added more and more passengers, the cost for B would go up and E would become lower. So I know the upper limit that we are going to place in the number of passengers is going to be, the options here are less than 50, at least 40, less than 40, at least 40, less than 50, at least 50. The answer can only be this. If it was at least 40, you can also include a number like 5,882. And then variable cost per passenger for B will exceed that of C, and then B might end up having a greater amount. So one of these two is going to be the answer. Okay, this is still in the running, worthy of consideration. Let's look at C. Variable cost, fixed cost is 300, difference of 300, 750 and 450. Variable cost per passenger is 6.5 and 2.5. Okay, and then 17.5x and 18x. Yes, C can exceed. When the kilometer increases, C can exceed. But because the kilometer is fixed, number of passengers are being increased or decreased. Because variable cost per passenger is lower in case of C, if you have more passengers, the cost of E, if you have more passengers, cost of E would go up. So nice. C is also still in the running, not because of fixed cost or variable cost per passenger, but because of variable cost per kilometer. This is important. Now let's look at D. 650, 8.5, 4.5. 650, E wins by 100, 8.5 and 6.5. So D wins now by 2. And then variable cost per kilometer, 18x and 17.5x. D is winning at these two positions. Can you also see now one important thing? B is not as influential as D, because with greater number of passengers, D's cost will go up the maximum. In fact, D is the only one worth considering out of all of these, because with greater number of passengers, both B and D's cost will go up. But D has a higher cost than B. 650 is higher than 500, 8.5 is greater than 7, and 18x is greater than 4x. So if E ends up beating D, also C is less than D. 650 is higher than 450, 8.5 is greater than 2.5, and 18x is equal to 18x. So if E ends up beating D, our life would be simple. Why we engaged in this analysis was, otherwise you would end up making 5 equations and 5 solving. If you notice that E has to only beat D, your work will become far, far easier. So cost for D, okay, this time I will not use the table, I will make the equation. Fixed cost for D is 650. Variable cost per passenger is 8.5p. And variable cost per kilometer is 18x and this has to be less than 750 plus 6.5p, and next what you get is plus 17.5x. I hope you don't mind that this takeoff of plane. Okay, let me work. P's come to the left. I get 2p is less than 100 minus 0.5x, or p is less than 50 minus 0.25x. If you are able to reach this condition, now see, p has to be less than 50 minus 0.25x, where x was distance traveled by a. If x was distance traveled by a, at worst it can be 0. At worst it can be 0. But if it is 0, then the ratio of distances for a, b, c, d, it has to be positive. If it has to be positive, can you conclude from this? P has to be less than 50. The number of passengers that have traveled in all these four boxes have to be less than 50. Therefore, the cost now will be clearly... The number of passengers will clearly be less than 50, and that will ensure that the cost for train is the maximum. Question number 3 also done. Let's get to question number 4. If the total cost of a trip for train B was greater than that for train D. Okay. Train B has a greater cost than train D. If you notice, fixed cost is higher for train D. Variable cost per kilometer, this amount is also higher for train D. This is 4x, this is 18x. Of course, D is winning. This is 650, this is 500. Of course, D is winning. Which of the following is definitely true regarding the number of passengers in train B and D? The only way B can end up beating D is if there are more passengers in train B. Because fixed cost, D is winning. Variable cost per kilometer cumulative, it is getting 4x, it is getting 18x. Here also D is winning. The only way B ends up beating D is if the number of passengers in B is greater than that in D. And I believe that is the first option. The number of passengers in train B was greater than the number of passengers in train D. This should be the answer. And all your questions are done.